Hello, in this video we will look at editing a PDF form using GNU Emacs. To start, we have to enable the annotation. Then we can use tab to move forward and shift tab to move backwards through the fields. Now to edit a field, we press E. So let's edit a text box. We'll call it city. Next, we will edit a dropdown. Again, press E and you get a select. Use the mini buffer to select one of the values. Let's select France. Now, let's edit a radio box. A checkbox or a radio box can be toggled using T. You can disable. Now, let's save the file. Doc view, save form. To ask for a file name, let's call it field1.pdf. If the file exists, it will ask you if you want to overwrite. Now let's verify this new file. In Firefox, we'll copy this file name, call it field1. Let's verify the values. You have city, France, and driving license selected. That's all for this video. Thanks.
Hello, in this video we will look at desktop and window management in GNU Emacs. We'll start with task view. Top row shows all the desktops and rest of the images are the active windows in that particular desktop. You can tap to select. And double tap to activate a particular window. You can use M to move selected windows to any of the desktops at the top. Let's check the third desktop. Let's bring it back to the second desktop. And the best part, you can select multiple windows and form a group by pressing G. Then you can select any of the windows in this group to activate the complete group. That's all for this video. Thanks.
Hello. In this video, we will look at screen mirroring using GNU Emacs Run WFT. Select an interface. Now it will scan for all the available devices for screen mirroring. I will select my TV, which is an LG WebOS TV. If you don't decline, it will start streaming. Let's change some buffer to check the visuals. Now, to terminate the session, just click on quit. That's all for this video. Thanks.
Hi, Leo here. So the next part is silence, and you can think of the subtitles as text on a slide. Audio will be back in a couple of minutes. Audio will be back in 2 seconds.
Thank you.
In this video, we will look at renaming a method across multiple files in a project. Let's start with semantic simref symbol. Now we have the references. Let's use the menu to open all these occurrences. Now to rename it, we have to use rename symbol in openheads. Let's rename it to _1. We will verify it by compiling the project. Let's open the messages buffer to see the results more clearly. No errors. That's all for this video. Thanks. Yeah.